The day had finally come. We grabbed our packed breakfast and hit the road as early as possible. First stop, the town of Olentin Temple, where we would catch a mountain train. They say anticipation is the most exciting part of any journey, and that was true. Our excitement kept growing as we waited to board the train. The 90 minutes ride took us through breathtaking scenery all the way to Aguas Calientes. The lush green mountains, flowing rivers, and every detail showcased nature's charm. We passed the Inca terraces and the vibrant cornfields adding to the view. At Aguas Calientes, the gateway to the ancient ruins of Machu Picchu, we hopped on a short bus ride that took us even closer to the site. As we climbed higher, we started to glimpse the mountain's beauty and the mysterious aura that surrounded them. And finally, Machu Picchu, one of the world's most iconic archaeological sites, often called the Lost City of the Incas. Built in the 15th century under the rule of the Inca Emperor Pachacuti, Machu Picchu is thought to have been a royal estate or a secret site. A century later, it was abandoned after the Spanish conquest, escaping the destruction that befell other Inca sites. The jungle slowly overtook the stone structures until it was discovered in 1911. The site is famous for its sophisticated dry stone construction, where precisely cut stones fit together without any mortar. Machu Picchu is divided into two main areas, the agricultural sector and the urban sector. The agricultural sector is made up of terraced fields used for farming, while the urban sector contains the main ruins, including temples, plazas, and residential areas. Machu Picchu is a marvel of Inca engineering and a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Its massive yet intricate architecture blends seamlessly with the stunning natural landscape, creating a perfect harmony between human and nature. Towering above the terraces and the stone ruins is one Picchu mountain, rising about 206 meters as mist is swarming up from the Urubamba River below. We were lucky to have a guide who loved taking photos of us, and he was pretty good at it. Finally, visiting Machu Picchu and witnessing its incredible landscape firsthand was an awe-inspiring, almost spiritual experience, one I will never forget. Two days later, we were back on the road, this time heading to the Picchu mountain range. We went by the Red River, which gets its name from the erosion of a sandstone rich in iron oxide, which turns the water in a deep reddish hue. But this rare natural phenomenon only happens during the rainy season. We also spotted plenty of alpacas and llamas along the road. They seem to love the environment here even more than the other places we visited. The Pocoyo mountain range is known for its stunning seven-color mountains, also called the Rainbow Mountains. As we entered the mountains, the road got rougher, making it difficult to film or to take pictures. It was a dirt road, full of rocks, and just wide enough for a small bus. With the sharp turns along the way, we couldn't help but admire our driver's skills. After about 3 hours, we finally reached our starting point for the hike. From there, we had to walk up to the top of the Rocky Mountain ahead of us. Pocoyo is known for its series of colorful mountains, and we found ourselves surrounded by the incredible magic of the Rainbow Mountains. The view was absolutely stunning. I heard that before 2015, these mountains were covered in snow and ice, but due to climate change, the snow has melted, revealing the vibrant color of the sediments beneath. The Peruvian government opened the area to tourism in 2015. While the cause of this natural wonder is concerning, the beauty here is truly breathtaking. We climbed up to our destination, the peak with the stone forests. These natural sculptures, shaped by erosion over millions of years, form a surreal and captivating landscape. The wind was fierce that day, so strong it sometimes made it hard to keep our eyes open. And as we climbed higher, the air grew thinner, making it harder to breathe. Finally, we reached the top, 4,960 meters above the sea level. Hooray! The colors of the mountains shift with the sunlight throughout the day, adding to the magical atmosphere. This ever-changing display of the nature's artistry is truly something to behold. The Rainbow Mountain experience exceeded all my expectations, and the stunning sights will stay with me for the rest of my life.